It's been a few nights without that.
For at least 12 victims, several police departments and federal investigators, a face to a mysterious shooter. It's been more than a month since the first reported highway shooting. 10 days after police announced their search, they're confident they've caught the right person.
We stand behind and have no further evidence that other people are involved in this.
The case began on the highways, and most of the evidence came from drivers on the roads. Just a day after police linked the shootings, a witness gave them a key piece of evidence, a license plate number. Police tracked that to a dark green car that matched victims' descriptions. That led police to another key, a bullet found inside a nearby home. That bullet matched slugs in 11 of the highway shootings. Whitaker's name connected to a nearby home. Then came a tip of a bag of shell casings near Grandview Road. Fingerprints matched Whitaker.
Police cannot do this alone. We would not be here but for the tips that came in.
Police kept track of the dark green car, even as it sped on highways, inching up to other cars as the shooter was described to do. That happened just 2 days ago. Today, Whitaker is being held on a $1 million cash bond. His next stop, the courtroom.
I talked to one of the victims who was able to describe the green car, and I asked her, does this Dodge Neon look familiar? She said it does, but she's still apprehensive to say this is the guy, although she hopes the shooter has been tracked down. Live in Kansas City, Brenda Lise Gonzalez, 41 Action News.